And this is our YouTube channel, Decode ITES. Decode ITES provides you single learning platform for multiple IT technologies. Today we will be discussing about server roles under SQL Server principles. Topics that we will cover today are server roles, type of server roles, and script to list permission of customized server roles. As discussed in last session, SQL Server principles has two components, logins and server roles. We have discussed logins, types of logins, and how we can create logins in last video. Today we will be discussing server roles and server role types. Server roles. Server roles are security principles to control access of other principles. Server roles are server scope and provide server level permissions to logins. Microsoft SQL Server comes up with two types of server roles, fixed and user defined. Fixed server roles are also known as built-in or default server roles. By default, Microsoft SQL Server gives you 9 default server roles. DBAs or database security admins can use these logins to provide permissions to logins created on SQL instance. User-defined server roles are also known as customized server roles. User-defined server roles were introduced in SQL Server 2012. In case fixed server roles are not sufficient for your environment, you can create a user-defined server role with permissions according to your environment or your project requirements. User-defined server roles. User-defined server roles are also known as customized server roles. User-defined server roles were introduced in SQL Server 2012. In case fixed server roles are not sufficient for your environment, you can create user-defined or customized server role on basis of your requirements. Types of fixed server roles. Microsoft SQL Server comes up with 9 fixed server roles: sysadmin, bulk admin, DB creator, disk admin, process admin, security admin, server admin, setup admin, and public. We will be discussing each role in detail in coming slides. Sysadmin. Sysadmin is most powerful server role in SQL Server. This role makes you server owner and you are free to perform any activity. In other words, sysadmin server role is a dream for everyone in SQL world. Every application owner, application developer, database developer wants sysadmin, but DBAs should be very restricted to give it because this can harm your system or it can compromise your data. Sysadmin role overrules all security checks and restrictions made at login level. Sysadmin role can manage other logins and server roles, whether fixed or user defined. Sysadmin should be controlled and provided to restricted people only. I have seen none other than DBAs have sysadmin roles in production environment. Also, in some of the restricted environments, even only highly skilled senior DBAs have sysadmin permissions. Rest of the junior DBAs will have lower privileges. Login with sysadmin not needed direct access on database. Sysadmin role supersede DB level access. Login can manage DB level user and objects with sysadmin role. Bulk admin server role. Bulk admin server role is made for bulk insert operations. Bulk insert operations are inserting data from files to SQL Server tables and vice versa. Bulk admin has privilege to deal with files laying outside of SQL Server. Bulk admin access provide permission to execute bulk command. Further access on table and files at operating system will also be required. This means this role gives you a permission at SQL Server to push data from files to SQL Server tables, but this will not give access on files or OS. For that, you need to contact your OS team so that you can have sufficient privileges at file system and over the file. So when you run command using SQL Server or command line, SQL Server can use your ID to access files and push data to SQL Server. Bulk admin role plays important role while working with ETL tools, extract, transform, and load. BCP utility is given by Microsoft to use bulk insert. DB creator server role. DB creator, as name implies, is for creation of databases. DB creator gives the privilege to create a database on SQL instance, useful for an application that needs to create new database on timely basis or for developers to create new DBs in non-cloud environment. Logins with create database will become the owner of database by default. Login will be able to perform any operation on particular DB because they are the owner after creation. Disk admin server role. Disk admin server role is legacy one and still available to use. Logins with disk admin server role can manage backup devices. Process admin server role. Process admin server role gives you a permission to manage sessions at SQL Server. Logins with the role can terminate user session. DBA should think before providing this role because untested or fewer experienced individuals can cause issues with currently running processes at SQL Server. Setup admin. Logins with setup admin can create, alter, or drop linked servers. All these three server roles are very rarely used. In my last 13 years of experience, I haven't seen any environment where these server roles are in use. Security admin server roles. Security admin server role is very crucial because this can manage logins or the access of your SQL Server instance. Although I haven't seen any environment using security admin specifically because this task is limited to DBAs and DBAs use sysadmin role most of the time. Logins with security admin can manage your logins like alter, delete, disable, or changing password of SQL logins. Logins with security admin can provide control server permissions. These logins can manage database users and securables in case they have database access. That means if you are a security admin, you can create a login, but to provide access on particular database or database objects, you should have database level permissions. In case you only have a security admin permission at server level and you don't have any permissions at database level, you just can create a login with required permissions at server level. You can't assign any permission at database level. Cannot change password of sysadmin because sysadmin is super role. Sysadmin is above to security admin. So security admin can't change the password of sysadmin logins. Server admin. Server admin is very powerful role and is almost near to sysadmin. Login with server admin server role can manage server level configurations. Although DBAs used to manage server level configurations and they use sysadmin most of the time. That makes this role very rarely used. Logins with this role can shut down the SQL services. So DBAs should be very restricted to give this permission or very selective to give this permission to required persons only. Other than this, member of this role can create or alter endpoints. Public server role. Public server role is a special one because every login is a part of public server role by default, and you cannot add or remove any login to public server role. Permissions assigned to public server role will automatically to be inherited to the logins assigned. You can change the permissions of public server role. That means you can assign additional permissions to public server role and those permissions will automatically be inherited to all the logins available at your SQL instance. So be careful and double check while assigning any additional permissions to public server role. Query to check access granted to public server role because you can grant additional permissions, so there are multiple times DBA need to list down those permissions for security checks and trace the security incidents or security vulnerabilities. You can use this query to review the permissions assigned to your public server role. So let's move to my SQL Server instance and we will see what all permissions I had given to my
public server role.
When you connect to your SQL Server instance, you can go to securities, and in server roles, you can see these 9 available fixed roles. So bulk admin, DB creator, disk admin, process admin, public, security admin, server admin, setup admin, and sysadmin. These are 9 fixed roles available by default with SQL Server. So let's see what all permissions I had given to my public role. This is the query that you can use to list down the permissions assigned to public server role. When you execute it, it shows that this particular role is currently having view any database and connect permissions. So let's go to public server role and assign some additional privileges. Let's see, let's grant the control permissions and endpoint changes alter. So when you run it, you can see this particular role is having control permissions as well as endpoint alter permissions. Previously, this role is having only connect permissions. Now, public role can alter the endpoints as well. So these permissions will automatically be inherited to all the logins available at my SQL Server instance or available at your SQL Server instance. We have discussed 9 fixed server roles. Now let's move to customized or user-defined server roles. User-defined server roles. As discussed at the start of this lesson, user-defined server roles were introduced in 2012 and also known as customized server roles. You can create user-defined server roles by SSMS or T-SQL. Before creating user-defined server roles, you must understand what kind of permissions you can give to that role. You can grant only server-level permissions to user-defined server roles. You can execute sys.fn_built-in_permissions to list down all permissions. You can create a role with extra permissions over fixed role or create a role with no fixed role permissions and only specific permissions. This is the command that you can use to find what all type of permissions you can give to user defined server roles. Let's move to SQL Server instance and we will run this command to see what all options we have. To create customized server roles, you first need to understand what all permissions you can give to particular server role. Microsoft gives you a set list from which you can select the permissions, and those all permissions are server scoped. This is the command that you can use. When you run it, it gives you 51 options in SQL Server 2019 editions. These options may vary version to version. You can see we have some roles available for availability group. We have some permissions for endpoint. We have some permissions for login, some permissions for server level changes. So you can assign any permissions from this list to your customized server role. How to create, alter, or drop a server role using SQL Server Management Studio or T-SQL? How to create customized server role? So let's start how we can create it. First, you need to connect your SQL Server instance. You need to go to securities, add server roles, do right click and click on new server role. At first step, you need to enter your customized server role. So my customized server role name will be test server role. Now assign the permissions or secure labels to this role. I will give availability group permission, and from server I will give control server permission, and I will give alter endpoint members. From this particular option, you can add any particular login to which you can assign this customized role. So let's see if we have any login available. So we will use this login. This login will be a part of this server role.
all permissions that we will assign to this particular cache server role will automatically be granted to this login membership. Other than permissions, if you want that your particular customized server role should have a permission of any fixed role as well, so you can select any of the role from here. If you don't want, you can just say okay and your login will be created only for the permissions you have mentioned. So let's see, I will give him an additional role of DB creator. Once you click OK, you can see under server role, you can find test server role. A new customized server role is created. We have seen how we can create customized server role using SSMS. Now we will see how we can create it using T-SQL. To create a server role from T-SQL, you first need to go to master database. Then you can create your server role using create space server space role space your customized server role name. And so click OK, your server role will be created. So we will refresh the server role pane and we can see test server role underscore T-SQL is created. Now we will assign the permissions, alter server role. We are altering this server role and adding member TET under this role. Add server role DB creator, add member test server role. Now we are altering DB creator fix server role to add our customized server role test server role underscore T-SQL to this server role. We are granting control server permissions to server role and we are granting alter endpoint permissions. So we have created server roles using SSMS and server role using T-SQL.
To list permissions of customized roles, when you create user defined or customized server role at SQL Server, you can assign list of server level permissions to that role. This script will list down all the permissions assigned to server role. This will be very helpful to know what all permissions a particular user defined server role is serving. Let's move to SQL instance and we will test this query.
How to check what all permissions you have assigned to customized server role? You can check it from GUI, but it will be a long method because there are a list of permissions and you need to validate and review all tabs and all permissions for this. I have written a script for you. You can just execute this script and it will list down all the permissions assigned to any customized server role. So when you run it, it's showing test server role having two permissions. One is control server permissions and one is alter. Also, this role is a part of DB creator fix server role. So this role will be having three primary permissions. One, all permissions of DB creator fix server role, and additional permissions is control server and alter endpoint. If you remove this all commands and run this complete command, it will list down all the logins which are associated with customized server role. So it will also help you to list down the logins which are using this role. When you execute it, it's now showing that test server role is assigned to member TT. In case in your environment you are using customized server roles or planning to use customized server roles, you can use this script and keep it handy for your future reference.
We have completed our today's session of server roles under SQL Server principles.
Thanks for watching. Do like, share, and comment our videos. Also, subscribe to our channel.